Hello from the Bureau with a severe weather update on the heatwave conditions and elevated fire dangers across southern Australia. So at the moment we have heatwave warnings that extend across southern Australia into the southeast, and they're forecast to contract into southeastern Australia over the weekend. Fire danger ratings are currently moderate to high. However, we move towards Friday, the winds start to pick up over South Australia and Western Victoria, elevating the fire dangers to extreme, with fire weather warnings likely. So if you live within these areas, it's important to have your fire plan ready to go. So taking a look at the maximum temperatures, we're forecasting today maximums to reach the low to mid 40s right across this region here, and a high of 38 degrees for Adelaide. For Thursday, where the temperatures will start to increase again for Adelaide and a top of 40 degrees, and also increasing through southern Victoria, a maximum of 33 degrees, while Hobart gets to 28 degrees. Thursday, however, is going to be a particularly uncomfortable and hot night for the people that live across South Australia, with the minimum temperatures just getting down to the high 20s, and even just down to 30 degrees for Port Augusta. For Adelaide, getting down to 26 degrees. And then by Saturday, maximum temperatures continuing to be really high as this heat continues to be brought down in the hot northerly winds. However, what we can see is this cooler air in these light yellow colours. So that is relief that's on its way with a strong cold front that's forecast across South Australia during Friday and then Victoria during Saturday. So we'll have a look now at the wind and the rain. So let's have a look at this trough and cold front that's responsible for bringing these elevated fire dangers and heatwave conditions. So here on Friday, you can start to see that it starts to get quite unstable, with some showers and storms developing during the afternoon as that cold front crosses. However, these showers and storms are coming from high-based cloud, with very little rain expected to reach the ground. And there's also the potential for dry lightning that can be a concern for fire ignition on the ground. Then on Saturday, that cold front will cross Victoria, and it will bring showers and storms to western and central parts of Victoria, and relief to the high temperatures as well. So if you live within these areas, it's important to stay up to date with the latest Bureau's forecasts and warnings via the app, social media and website, and listen to the advice from your local emergency services. Bye for now.